Hey, this is Ralph, and I want to continue working on these layouts. So, tackled the first two in the previous video, and let's see if we can't take care of layouts 3 and 4. They look like two column layouts, actually kind of mirrors of each other. We have with layout 3 a two column layout with a very noticeable sidebar and then a header and a main section. Layout 4 also has a sidebar, but the sidebar is on the left. Good news is the HTML should be pretty identical for these two, just a slight modification to the styling. No footer though, so I'm going to head over to my code, and my last one that I was doing was layout 3, so I'm going to do a file save as. Last one I was doing was layout 2, so I'll call this layout3.html. And there is a header and there's a main section, but there is definitely a sidebar. And I'm going to take this sidebar, since it starts at the top of the page, I'm going to move it to the very front of the lineup. So my sidebar is up here, and I'll use a float to decide, does it go to the left or does it go to the right? Alright, so head back up here, and just to kind of keep organized, I'll make a new rule up at the top for my sidebar. Now my sidebar doesn't have to be the rule above the header rule and the main rule, but I like to organize my styles pretty much in the same sequence that the elements occur in the page. So my sidebar, and let me just look at my picture once again, sidebar is off to the right, okay, and then we have our header and our main section. So my sidebar, I'll go ahead and do a background color of green. I'll set the width to 200 pixels. Let's try that one. And let's go ahead and float it to the right. And I'll set the height to 400 pixels. So that's the only thing I'm going to do at the moment. Let's see what's happening. So I'll go ahead and save this, run this, launch in Firefox. And there we go. That's all it really took. Notice that I didn't have to set the width of my header or my main section. Those naturally will be as wide as they can be, and that's what I wanted. I don't want to close that. So my sidebar is off to the right, and let me go ahead and correct my text. This is layout 3, so my title of my page should be layout 3. My headline 1 should be layout 3. Save that. There we go, and refresh. So, three key parts of the page: a sidebar, header, main section. I did the sidebar first. What happens if I did the sidebar second or last by accident? Let's say I left it over here. We'll just take that sidebar, pop it down there, hit save, and I'm going to learn where to click. Go back to my Firefox. There we go. Refresh. There we go. Look what happened there. So my sidebar is floating to the right, but it's occurring after my blue main section. I wanted it to occur all the way up here at the very top. So just go ahead and keep an eye on that and make sure. I'll just Control Z to undo. It's in the right spot. Okay, layout 4 should be pretty easy for us. I'll just do a file, save as, layout4.html. Layout 4. Only change I need to make here, by the way, is on my sidebar. Instead of floating to the right, I will float it to the left. Save that. Browser refresh. And I'm looking at the wrong page. Let's go to layout 4. Enter. And there it is. Sidebar is on the left. Header and main sections are on the right. Alright, now there is one thing I'm leaving out because these are blank mockups. Something I do like to do with a floating sidebar. For instance, if my sidebar is 200 pixels wide and floating on the left, I'll go to my header and I'll do a margin left 200 pixels, and on my main I would do a margin left 200 pixels. Now you're not going to notice any change whatsoever when I refresh. So like, well, what was the value of that? Well, the value of that occurs is if like my main section were to be a little bit taller. Check this out. If I went to my main and I made it like height 340 pixels, save this, browser, refresh. See how my main, it's not wrapping underneath that sidebar. I don't want that to happen. I want my main section to stay in that nice vertical line. This would stand out to you if you had content, especially text content, on this page, but that's the basic idea right there. So that's layout 3 and layout 4. Where's my PDF file? So basic two column layout, sidebar on the right, sidebar on the left. The trick to that is sidebar is the first element, and then you either float it to the right, float it to the left, and that's all there is to it. Looks like layout 5 is a three column layout, but it looks very similar to our layout 3, just this secondary sidebar. And layout 6 is also pretty similar, except its header goes all the way across, spanning all three columns. So I think what I will do is I'll stop this video here. That takes care of layouts 3 and 4, and I'll tackle the last two in the next video.